Let's talk about some of the major issues with the August fortnightly edition, and these focus on tiger census, RTI and education. So some of the MCQ trackers from this edition, there has been a change in the definition of tiger census, which is very, very important question. So we have said that the tiger population has increased. So far we were considering the tiger in the age group of 1.5 years and above, and now we have changed the definition to 1 year and above, and that's one of the reasons for that. Then we have phytosanitary certification, which talks about the quarantining the agricultural import coming in. Methyl bromide has been used as one of the chemicals in the fumigation. Fall armyworm was one of the invasive species which affected the maize crop last year, and because of which this year a lot of maize was imported. So again, a very important question. IUCN classification, every time you have one or two questions. So the vulnerable species, which is Gaur, Indian bison, has been mentioned in this edition. As coming up with the US presidential election, you have different candidates giving their different plans. So you have new green deal, Green Marshall Plan, so those are important. Colistin is important. Now this is used to as a growth promoter in most of the animals, and this basically creates ready fat or increases the fat content very fast and brings develops the poultry in a shorter life span. So that has been used, but it's a kind of antibiotic which has been harmful in long run. You have Kangech, which is a kind of mushroom. B12, which is again a very important case study, as we'll discuss. Higher education and RTI are some of the important species. So Kangech, as I said, is a rare Himalayan mushroom which is seen, grows mainly in Jammu Kashmir, very, very important. Colistin, again, as I said, it's used as an antibiotic promoter, and therefore you have lots of resistant antibiotic resistance that has been developed, but it's a kind of multi-drug antibiotic resistance that has been talked about in this aspect. Again, we are talking about a national action plan on antimicrobial resistance, which aims to gradually eliminate kind of importance of the critically important antibiotics in animal use. Now some of the highlights from this edition again are Chandrayaan 2. So it's a second India's mission to moon, which talks about the study of cool traps that would be there and record the fossils in the early solar system at the south pole of the moon. So that's one of the unique missions that India has. Gaur or the Indian bison, we have already discussed. Then you have the UN climate summit, which would be held in the month of September this year. So September 23rd to 29th, very important phase where you have lot of events coming up with climate change, environment. So definitely very, very important. We are also aiming to reduce the greenhouse gases emissions by 45% in the next 11 years. So that's the target. We are trying to limit it to zero by 2050, and it should not rise above 1.5 degrees Celsius of the pre-industrial level. So those are the targets that we have set. We are also talking about Green Climate Fund, which is being established. Norway and Germany, how they are doubling their contribution. You have numerous activists which are working for the same. Similarly, you have numerous environmental activists which have been killed in the recent. Philippines is one of the major areas which is most vulnerable, it's believed. Latin America is again one of the places which has witnessed excessive killing of the environmental activists in the recent days. In India, we say 69% of the area is a dryland area. So dryland population is vulnerable to mainly the problems of water stress, problems of drought that could be seen, or degradation of the habitat. So the idea is to reach to maximum people and limit the pre-industrial level of 1.5 degrees Celsius, as we said. So for the first time, we have also done a research where the Rubik Cube solutions have come up with nearly 43 quintillion possible solutions for just one solution to reach, and that's finally the Rubik's Cube being solved. Also, we have lots of researches going on, especially at University of Michigan, where organic semiconductors are built in despite of the inorganic semiconductors which are being used. In Chittoor, you have Tirumala Temple, and that's a place where 83% of the wastewater is treated and used for non-potable purposes, mainly in the gardens, forest area, or the regions where sandalwood is grown. Also, we have a lot of activity of NGT that has been seen. Rat hole mining in Meghalaya is one good example. Then you have lots of other developments, mainly in Uttarakhand, where we have seen timber mafia in Odisha is one of the major concerns. You have a case study in this edition where we have been talking about Odisha's Nayagarh district, where the work has been done in the Dingajari village, and this is because of a lot of smuggling activities going on in the adjoining hills. You have streams dying off, urbanization taking up phase. You have women who are coming in front and taking an active role in promoting and conserving the environment. Tiger census, as I have already talked about in the very initial state, but yes, you have five states where the population has declined, and that's really a remarkable notice. So it's Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, where you have a decline in the population which has been registered. The states with highest population are again important. So Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka and Uttarakhand have the highest population of the tigers. RTI Amendment Act has come up. Now, there has been a lot of controversies on this, because some of those believe that this has given more power to the center. Center becomes extraordinarily powerful. Again, so far, RTI has been performing very nicely. You have lots of cases that have been resolved under RTI. But this Amendment Act, which has recently come up, would bring in a kind of limit to the powers of the RTI at the state level. The amendments basically cannot stand the scrutiny of Article 19(1)(a) of the Constitution, which focuses on RTI. So what are the gist of amendments are important? 5-year terms or up to 65 years of the age, whichever is earlier, has been removed from the amendment. From the act, sorry. Similarly, the status, term and the salary of the Chief Information Commission is now equal to that of the Chief Election Commission, would be reduced. So that has been another a kind of fury for the RTI amendments and a kind of criticism which has come up. Similarly, there has been powers of the state to prescribe the terms of the salary, state in, and the status of the Chief Information Commissioners, both at the center and the state, from time to time. So, deletion of the appointment of deputy commissioners. So, those are some of the important changes that have come up with RTI. Climate change, as I said, US presidential elections coming up next year. So, you have four candidates coming up, each coming up with their different unique plan. So, Elizabeth Warren talking about a Green Marshall Plan, which is a commitment of $100 billion for the next 10 years. You have new Green Deal resolution, which has come up, which talks about promoting renewable energy by Joe Biden. Joe Biden talks about a kind of ambition for climate change. We are also talking about 100 days in office. Within the first 100 days, he would bring significant changes in terms of climate change. Kamala Harris talking about the Office of Climate and Environment Justice, bringing in much more accountability in the climate changes. Agriculture import and quarantining, as I said, has been a very important concern. Every year since last 10 years, we have registered one of the invasive species coming up in India, destroying the numerous local species. For example, in 2019, we had onion weed. It came from Africa, South Europe and West Asia. It affected the onion crop mainly in the regions of Maharashtra. So this is one example. And then you have the list that's there. So you can just memorize those. Those are really, really important from your prelims perspective, objective perspective. But yes, when it comes to import, we have certain rules and regulations. We have a phytosanitary certificate that has been attached to it. Now, countries like Hawaii do have trans-border quarantining at the boundaries itself. So at the airports, at the seaports, at the land ports, you have the quarantine or the checking that occurs. But in India, there is no such strict provisions. So only thing we check is a phytosanitary certification. So phytosanitary certification talks about that the product is coming without any pest infestation and the exporting country has that certificate with it. However, if that certificate is not given, what we do is we treat it with methyl bromide from 2 to 48 hours, and it's a basically a process of fumigation through which if there are any pests, those would be taken off. However, nearly half of the centers in India which provide quarantine facilities are functional. The remaining are not functional. Recently, there was a bribery case that was put up in 2017. You have Down Agro Sciences, which is a US-based company, which gave nearly $2 billion of bribe to the Indian officials based in Chennai, and that was where the regional quarantine plant was, and from there most of the officials have now been transferred because they were issuing fake phytosanitary certification. So those are the list of some of the important crops that were affected. So let's say fall armyworm, as we discussed in the starting, came from North and South America. It affected the maize crop mainly in the regions of Karnataka. But similarly, you have the barramundi seeds, which is the Asian sea bass, which is in the idea of fishery. Again, you have other countries which are strictly following it. For example, Nepal, after the acute encephalitis syndrome, Nepal has quarantined or restricted any product coming from India for few time. So in light of bioterrorism, this is really, really important to check. Now B12 is mainly found in animal sources. The plant-based diet really lacks it, but in India even the non-vegetarian population have significant deficiencies of B12 that is being registered. The reason being they feed mainly on chicken. Now chicken is one of the sources which is poor in B12. Some of the sources which are good in B12 are liver from goat and sheep. You have shrimp, goat meat, egg yolk, egg whole, you have buffalo meat. So those are some of the important sources when it comes to the non-vegan diet. We could say cow milk is a good example. So also you have the vitamin loss that takes place in the cooking process. So what happens is when people have, let's say, a problem of gastric problem or acidity problem, the secretion of HCl reduces, the pepsin level in the body reduces. As a result, the absorption of the B12 in the body also reduces. So overcooking damages the B12. That is very, very important. Again, there are other reasons through which you have B12 deficiencies that is registered, but B12 is required for overall growth to check the problems and issues of dementia. Higher education, you have lots of glitches coming up. You have the National Medical Commission Act of 2019, which basically replaced the MCI with the National Medical Council. We are also talking about the exit exam coming up, focusing on affordable quality medical education, bringing in medical professionals at par with the foreign professionals, conducting a kind of easing process for admissions to the colleges, bringing in a regulation in the admission fees for the medical colleges. Then you have 60% of the primary health cares which are running only on one doctor. So bringing in more experts into the field, similar to the concept of barefoot doctors which is present in China. So in 1960s, the government gave farmers the basic idea to have a basic medical and paramedical treatment that could be done in the rural area. So they trained the farmers itself to work as doctors, and those were known as barefoot doctors. So in India, we are now focusing on next, which is the national exit exam. That's the entrance test before the post-graduation, and that would be treated as the entry point for the post-graduation in medical studies. We have a lot of medical colleges in Karnataka, which most of which are in the private sector. You don't have good degrees for those. You have All India Council for Technical Education, which does not allow conventional disciplines because of the low employment probabilities that are seen. So a lot of graduates are coming up even from the technical branches, which face a lack of job security. Also, the skill report, the online skill assessment, VBox has done a study where it says 70% of the students from the polytechnic institutes were not employed in 2018, and this unemployment was only 53% 4 years back. So definitely there has been a poor education quality, because of which there has been a lack of employment opportunities coming up. We are now focusing on non-traditional courses on artificial intelligence, internet of things, cloud technology. But under those courses, again, the basics of engineering, the basics of sciences have been totally lost. And as a result, the product that is being created, the students that are coming out, are not proficient in their independent field. So definitely the quality of education has been suffering a lot. The next is the gender ratio. We are talking about World Health Organization standards, where we are talking about 950 52 girls per 1,000 boys, which is considered a balanced gender ratio for any of the states. In India, we had a very poor performing states, mainly Punjab and Haryana. Haryana indeed, where you have the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme, which had been launched. And it's for the first time in Jhajjar district, you have crossed the 6 ratio mark that was so far. So there has been definitely a growth in the female girl child birth that has been seen. You have numerous developments which have been seen. The Fogat sisters, then you have numerous bronze coming in the Olympics. So Sakshi Malik was another example. Miss Haryana Manushi Chullar from Haryana was again Miss India, Miss World. So again, remarkable developments. But still we have seen that you have low cost portable ultrasound machines which are coming up at very low cost from Alibaba or IndiaMart. And as a result, the issue of female feticide needs to be checked very, very carefully. We are moving from a generation of 3G and 4G internet to 5G internet. This would empower numerous new products, technologies, increase productivities and new technologies, bring in people with Internet of Things. When it comes to drug market, it's definitely alarming situation because cancer drugs are mainly contaminated. Cholesterol drugs have sheets of glasses that are seen. BP drugs have live bugs that are seen. With such poor, or I could say unethical systems of or the jugaad level of development with the pharma industry, it's definitely a time that generic industry should have some regulations for the drugs that are coming into the market. The poor quality where the regulations are being lax, or where you can say a lot of corruption is being practiced, it's a real harm for the local people. So those have been some of the major issues. The MCQs, the probable topics that could be there for your MCQs, we have discussed those in this session. We'll be bringing many such editions every fortnightly. So stay tuned, keep subscribed, have a wonderful day ahead.